This is a female patient, 34 years old, with long history of infertility. She is doing treatment for approximate last 10 years off and on. Patient has advanced case of polycystic ovaries with medications. Sometimes patient got dominant follicle, but she was never able to conceive yet. This is a TVS scan. Left ovary is visualized. We can see that ovary size and volume is increased. Sizes are written in the video. Ovarian echogenicity and thickness is also increased. There is no dominant or growing follicle seen. The largest is elongated follicle, 11 multiply 3 mm. 8 mm another follicle seen. There are multiple small follicles, approximate plus 20 number in both ovaries. These are grade 2 plus or gross polycystic ovarian disease. The right ovary is also enlarged, shows multiple small follicles with increased echogenicity and parenchymal thickness. Size and volume is increased. There is no growing or dominant follicle in the ovary. Although treatment is difficult in these patients, but many patients with medications got dominant follicles and were able to conceive. Patient also given this history that she got good size follicle many times, but never conceived. This is advice for all patients with long history of infertility that they must have a good TVS scan every year to rule out other minor causes of infertility other than polycystic ovaries. In this case, the uterus, endometrium, cervix appears normal. There is no fibroid, no any mass seen. But when we look at the endometrium, there is an hyperquake smooth nodule in the endometrial cavity. This is small, 8.8 multiply 5.5 millimeter. But the location of this polyp is in upper third uterine body endometrial cavity. This is the location where the fertilized egg attaches to the uterine walls and forms a gestation sac. Most of the polyps are asymptomatic, but polyps in this location can sometimes decrease chances to conceive if there are other causes like PCOS, which itself causes infertility. When diagnosed, the removal of these polyps are simple without any major surgery. And studies have found that when the polyps were removed, the pregnancy rate was increased up to 50%. So these endometrial polyps have been found to be associated with infertility. There have been association between PCOS and endometrial polyps. Obesity, overweight, oligomenorrhea, hormonal estrogen imbalance increases the risk of developing endometrial polyps. Other risk factors are chronic infection, multiparity, foreign bodies, estrogen secretion. These are benign and very rare, less than 2% can develop into carcinoma.